arrive very late in Havana, Cuba, and Fidel Castro has just come down from his suite in the Havana Hilton after days and days and days of little sleep. Mr. Castro, I can say, not as a politician, I have no right to talk of politics, I'm an entertainer, but as an old friend of Cuba, not a newcomer, 5 years I've been coming here and speaking of Cuba, you are a good neighbor. To me personally, you live right up there. Does he understand? And you're not noisy. And you're not noisy. And you have not come down to borrow any sugar. You have been a good neighbor.
Okay.
May I ask you, so that I don't look too naive, a tough question right off the bat?
And whether I'm a Democrat or Republican?
What are some of the stories you were telling me today?
I can't remember.
You can't remember?
Well, ask me what one of them was. Let me think.
We'll look it up here. We'll just cut this off for a minute. Then we're going to get our notes, Richard, huh? How do you remember Hamlet every night? I don't know.
Can Kennedy be defeated in 64?
Well, which one?
Magic moments there from The Tonight Show, starring the legendary Jack Paar. Jack Paar recently traveled with us on board QE2, and he was kind enough to come down to the studio and talk about The Tonight Show and his life and career leading up to it.
President Kennedy and I were born the same year, the same month, a few days apart. We had a lot of things in common, and then I mean that in the smallest possible sense, that we had a similar experience in the war. I was on Guadalcanal, and he was out there with his PT boat, and we became quite close because his PT boat was out one night in what we call the slot. That's where the Japanese ships would come down, and the PT boats would go out. And by mistake, actually, one of the destroyers, Japanese destroyers, the Akiri, slammed into him, killed one or two of the men, and eight of the men escaped and swam ashore. They were there for many, many days without water. Some were badly burned. And the President Kennedy, then John Kennedy, Lieutenant John Kennedy, was very heroic. He saved the men. And he eventually wrote on a coconut with a knife his position, where he was, and gave it to some natives who, in a canoe, took it over to a place called Rondova, I believe. And there was an Australian coast watcher who read this coconut, radioed the United States forces out here, and they were saved. Now, I came out here again, in 1962, on a small boat from New Guinea down, and looked for the man who actually saved the president's life. His name was Ben Kivu, and I actually found him and brought him back to the United States, and it was a great thrill for our president to meet the little man who saved his life. And that was a great experience for me.
Now, when John Kennedy's brother Bobby appeared on your show, he caused quite a stir, didn't he?
In an interview one night, I was asking Bob some questions about a man called Jimmy Hoffa. Jimmy Hoffa was a union leader of the Teamsters Union, and suspected of gangsterism and all kinds of vicious things, and he and Bobby were enemies, and on my show Bobby made some remarks that ended up in a lawsuit.
Let's take a quick look at those remarks.
The question then is Hoffa an improvement over Dave Beck?
Oh, there's no comparison between Mr. Hoffa and Mr. Beck. Mr. Beck was just a thief. This is not...
We may be in court together, you and I.
I hope the hell you know what you're doing, because I don't play. I'm just...
What happened after that?
I was sued, and Bobby Kennedy was sued for $2 million, I believe. And that explains that reference to the English audience who wonder. Hoffa was... incidentally, before I left the country a couple of weeks ago, there was many rumors about the President Kennedy's assassination. And the last one I read as I left was that there was a theory that Hoffa was behind it. He himself, you know, Hoffa was found in a cement... I don't know whether they ever found him, come to think of it.
No, I don't think they did.
Ever found the body, I guess, yes.
After the assassination of President Kennedy, a whole nation, in fact, a whole world, was in mourning. Let's take a look now at Bobby Kennedy's appearance on your show just after that terrible incident in Dallas.
I feel deeply honored tonight to share some of that lifetime with you and to discuss it with a man whose own life reminds us of what brother really means, the distinguished Attorney General of the United States, Mr. Robert Kennedy. Great honor to have you here, sir.
Thank you.
Well, wait till the folks just sit down quietly for a moment, and then we're just going to talk about... I know the thing closest to your heart at this very moment is the Memorial Library. And may I just ask some personal questions about how is Mrs. Kennedy, Mrs. John Kennedy?
She's fine, really. Making a adjustment and doing it well. She spends... most all of her time with her children now, and I think she's making a good deal of progress.
Is it true that you're over there to see the children a great deal, and Senator Ted is,
yeah.
Ted Kennedy goes there at night and reads them comic books?
No.
Is that comic book?
No. He goes over and tells stories at night after he finishes work, and tells the two children, and then Dave Powers, who worked for my brother at the White House and was a great friend for many, many years, goes over and at lunchtime and has lunch with John. So they see some men in their lives now.
What do you think, sir, was your brother's greatest contribution?
Well, I think really he made Americans feel young again.
Yes.
And I think that he gave all of us more confidence in the country, more confidence in the struggles that we're involved in internally and externally will be successful, more confidence in our efforts with those who are opposed to us. I think also he gave great confidence in people who lived in other countries, great confidence in the United States and in its leadership, and that we were dedicated to certain principles and ideals, and that we would live up to them and, if necessary, fight for them. And so that I think it changed over a period of years that our own feelings, as well as the feelings of other peoples around the world.
Yeah.
Very moving scenes. Now, let's move on to Judy Garland, who I know was also very dear to you.
Well, Judy and I were friends.